Hey, what's going on, guys and girls? Our colleague Phoenix here, and welcome to episode number 29 of my Subnautica Season 3 Let's Play series. So, for right now, we are in creative mode. Just so I can show off this cave that I wanted to show off last episode. Now, I got told that the reason why the cave wasn't loaded properly is because I didn't reset my terrain. Now, I tried that after I finished recording and after I read that comment, and it didn't seem to make a difference. So we're in a creative world, so we can have a proper look at it, seeing as it's nice and freshly spawned. Look at you, you bugly bastard, you. Look at you. No, we can fuck with you for a minute, just because I can. What's your health like, buddy? I wonder. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. About 9 slashes in your dunzo. With a good old stasis rifle. Ooh. Don't know why I'm picking this shit up. There's no point. Okay, so now we can check out this the way we should have been able to check the cave out last episode. Give it a nice, proper, thorough look. Now, one thing I wanted to talk about is that I believe the cave crawler model has changed. So, for a lot of people on the Discord, seem to really like the old look of the cave crawler, but this is the new look now, and people didn't seem to really take to it very well, honestly. People did not like it. This is still only a 3-hit kill. Okay, so what do we got here? I'm gonna give this a nice good look, because, like I said, we didn't get to do it last episode. Ugh. It's pretty dope. Okay, so they're speckled rattlers. We can't do anything with them. Like with the really cool looking plants. Is there anything down here worth looking at? Like, to go down here is, I guess, pointless to a degree, it seems. And it seems like you just get stuck if you come down here. Excuse me, what? Oh yeah, we can go up here, can't we? There's always a way around. Why does it sound like I'm walking inside the Cyclops? Right? It sounds like I'm running on metal. This is pretty spacious in here. Pretty broad and open, actually. I can see why that guy decided to build in here. It's pretty fucking cool. I'm getting myself turned around now. Yeah, I could totally see building in here. The only thing he said is the bases were kind of flooding out still, even though there's clearly no water inside this cave. So they shouldn't be able to flood at all, but yeah, apparently they were. Alright, now I assume that there's been no build done today that would have made the teleporter functional. I don't believe. Yeah, no, this is clearly not operational right now. But this looks fucking amazing. Look at that. Look at that. That looks great. Looks so cool. Ah, well, I guess that's the cave system. Pretty much. I don't think there's really much else to see inside this cave, unfortunately, but because we're in creative mode, there was also something else I wanted to show you guys and girls a few episodes ago that we didn't get to show, it's gonna be a little bit of a pain to go there, I guess, because, you know, it's pretty far down in the water. What we should do is I'll just, no, on the way, I can't. I can build myself a, fabricator. Ha ha ha. Oh, the world is open. The world is my oyster in creative mode. I'll still manage to fucking be a screwhead at this game. Oh yeah, that's so quick. Makes me hard. What we got now? Lithium. I should build that. And I should also build one of these. Okay. Good, good. What's our depth now? Maximum depth? I don't know. What's our maximum depth potential? 1500 meters. Perfect. Now, I wanted to make a mobile vehicle bay. What the fuck was that? Oh, that's the ion power cells. Why does this take so long? Holy shit. Waiting all day. Thank you. Okay, now we actually need to surface. Speed 5. Whom. Speed of light ready. Launch out of the water. Ah. Speed 1. We need to hop out of here. Lay down this vehicle module. Actually, this is going to be a bit of a problem. If I make a prawn suit, it's going to fall to the fucking bottom of the world. Hopefully I can grab it as it goes to fall. No, it's gone. This couldn't be any more in my face if it wanted to be. Captain, all systems online. How far down did it fall? I only fell 63 meters, that's okay. What was it?
Morning, cataclysm.
What did it land on? It stopped it from falling. Oh no, it's just stuck in like midair. I mean, I can dig that. Hopefully when we go out there we can actually grab it before it falls through the fucking world.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Get ready. Get up in there. Now I'm gonna have to go to safety. Alright, so we need to get to a shallower area so I can do the upgrades that I need to do. Where are we in relation to the Aurora? Heading into deeper water. I don't really want to be heading into deeper water right now. Can I just up the speed to like 6?
Warning, cataclysm.
We're not gonna have as much lag problems as we would otherwise because of. Holy shit.
Warning, cataclysm.
Alright, now we're starting to get it. Alrighty, yep. Okay, this will do. Champ. Alright, now what do we need? I don't want to make a moon pool and shit, dude. Like, we don't need any of that crap. We just needed the MK3 upgrade, really. Just so we can make sure that when we jump out, we're fine. I guess I would love the jump jet upgrade, but that don't matter. For what we're planning on doing, that's completely irrelevant. Alright, so give me a minute to get over to where I want to go to, and I'll see you guys and girls there. Alright, guys and girls. So, I wanted to look in here. Check that shit out, dude. You know what that is? Look at it. Fucking mental. I believe that's the sea dragon egg. I don't think it's the sea emperor's egg. From my understanding, it's a sea dragon. Oh, it's a sea. Yeah, it's a sea dragon egg. Or it could be a sea emperor egg. I'm not sure. But this was recently added. That thing looks painful as fuck to squeeze out. That looks like it would be just a horrifying experience. Why would anyone want to do that? Oh, this has been broken. Remember all these here? I don't remember that one. I know they were probably there, but I just don't remember them. I don't care about the PDAs. I just wanted to come back and revisit this. One, to look at that egg. And two, just to see if there was anything I missed. Obviously not in my normal series, because we're in creative. Suggests that indigenous life forms were brought to this location and subjected to intensive gene manipulation. That thing is fucking horrifying, dude. Could you imagine if you go up to it and it just comes back to life and blah, just absolutely fucks you up? Like, these things were fucking
data pertaining to the
ripped to shit.
Being downloaded. Caution. Detecting atypical fluctuations in blood plasma proteins. A self-scan is strongly advised.
Nah, I don't have a fucking scanner on me.
Integrating new PDA data.
Wow. I really love this area. I remember looking at it last season. I think they just did such a good job on it. Like, look at that. It's got no fucking legs, though. That's a bit of an issue. Alright, well, anyway, guys and girls, that is going to be the end of this episode. In the next episode, I'm not sure what we're going to be doing, but we definitely won't be in creative mode. We'll be out exploring, having a good time. But if you like this video, remember to leave a like. If you want to see more, hit that subscribe button. And check me out on Twitter and Facebook and all that bullshit. And I hope you all have a lovely day. Alright, peace!